On day two of what could be a heat wave, we found people refusing to let the heat stop them in their tracks. As Gene Mackin shows us, they were sweating through every last hour of the sweltering day.
It's probably the last thing a lot of people would consider doing on a day that tested and even broke some high temperature records. But we found people out here racing in a 5K.
When runners reached the finish line at Dairy Field Park in Manchester, they were doused with a hose.
Woo.
And handed a bottle of ice cold water.
It was a little toasty out there.
Very hot.
Brutally hot.
It was hard. It was hot. It was really hot. The hills are killer.
They trudged 3.1 miles through the heat and up the hills for the Light Up the Night 5K to benefit the Mental Health Center of Greater Manchester.
Yes, it was so much work. It was great for such a good cause.
Awesome. Loved it. Perfect day for it.
The winner, Bedford High School senior Sam Daly.
I think 18:15, 18:17. So it was hot. So I was happy with that.
Organizers were relieved the heat didn't slow down their fundraiser.
I said the only reason I would cancel would be an ice storm, a lightning storm, a volcanic eruption, or an earthquake. Other than that, runners want to run.
And riders want to ride, and golfers want to golf. We found them giving a cold shoulder to the baking sun. They are going to play through, but take different paths to get there.
Well, these guys are walking, so they're braving it, and they're doing well, too. So,
walking's not for you.
No, not today.
And at the coolest spot of the day, only the setting sun could send crowds out of the pool at Livingston Park in Manchester.
And there was like a big line. I had to wait in a big, big line.
We had a blast. I mean, there was kids everywhere. It was packed.
And for this to be an official heat wave, it has to reach 90 degrees on Friday. In Manchester, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.